Please welcome the men's singles match onto court one, representing Singapore, Chow Huang. Representing England, Rajiv Usef.
So Raj Usef, the silver medalist from Delhi 4 years ago, comes out to play his third round match. And it could be a tight one, this, because he's playing Huang Chao from Singapore, a man born in Hubei province in China.
Red or black?
Red, maybe.
22 years ago.
It's
22
black.
Years ago.
Sure.
Not the top Singapore player, that's Derek Wong, of course, but Huang Chao was interestingly chosen to play in the bronze medal match against Kashyap Parapalli. Didn't win on that occasion. Rajiv Usef, of course, had beaten Kashyap in the semi-finals. Very comfortable wins over representatives from the Falkland Islands and Bangladesh. Hasn't really been tested. He's ranked 140. His father was a member of the Chinese national badminton squad, so plenty of pedigree. Raj Usef, not only did he win a silver medal in the individual event, of course a bronze medal in the team event in Delhi 4 years ago. The 27-year-old, born in Hounslow and still living in the London area, and his current ranking is number 26 in the world, and he too has had a straightforward route through against players from Zambia and Mauritius. This time around, Mike Walker has moved from the service judge's chair to the umpire's chair and going in the opposite direction. Kelvin Martin from Barbados. Judged, which I think is a better test, Morten, of what we saw in the team competition. Who's your favourite for this one?
Oh, you know, I don't really dare to say it, but in this match, Usef is the favourite to win. And I must say, he's a small favourite for me to win the whole tournament, but that's secret.
No.
I will not tell.
Okay. Despite losing, of course, to the Malaysian number one in the gold medal match, but such a tight game.
It was 19 in the third. Somehow, I just feel he's got a chance. But let's see. You know, that's way ahead of us.
Yes.
But it's a tough match for Usef. I think you're very right here. His opponent is a very attacking player. He's got a powerful smash. And somehow he just needs to mix it up a little bit. It's a little bit too one-sided how he's playing. But let's go into that later as the game progresses.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Huang Chao, Singapore. And on my left, Rajiv Usef, England. Huang Chao to serve, love all, play.
Yep. Early evidence of the power of
Absolutely fantastic smash to start off with. What a shot to play in this first rally. So crisp. Cross court, slightly reversed, catching his opponent off guard and on the wrong foot.
And the second smash isn't bad either.
Two. Love.
So we have to hope for England this is not continuing.
Serve is over. One, two. Two, all.
Smashing once again.
Three,
but so my feeling is that Usev will sort of settle in and he will get into that match here and he will start reading those matches much better. Obviously Huang will, you know, play winners now and again, but it will be much more difficult for him as the game goes on because Usev is settling in and really starting to get them back. And that's where I would like to see Huang sort of starting to be able to wary his game, change it a little bit, play some clears. As you can see, every time there's a shot towards the baseline, he is playing it down, either drop shot, slice, or smash.
That's nice.
Yeah, beautiful play.
Four, all.
So despite three fantastic smashes, it's still 4-4.
Usev has the lead for the first time. Once again, a very crisp finish, that one there. Good follow-up. Sort of mistakes that Usev will need to cut out.
Yeah. Good down the line. What Usev have to do, he's got to delay his shots just a little bit, disguise them a little bit, so opponent Huang can't really just go straight for it. He's got to hesitate a little bit, and that small hesitation will get Usev into the game. Yeah, he just goes for the big smash every
Eight,
single time.
Five.
And it's so difficult to play against. And I can understand why Usev is sort of shaking his head a little bit and saying, oh, what's happening here?
Well, it's a 3-point lead now.
Service over. Six, eight.
perhaps beginning to read a couple of the smashes at least.
Yeah, but it just shows how important it is to start getting those smashes back.
Seven, eight.
Much better by Rajiv Uzev here. His attack, sorry, his defense, much better. And Wang can't get through, and eventually he's punching that clear too long.
Play, please.
But good play by Uzev. Good defensive play, and that's what he needs to do.
3 points in a row for Yusuf now to draw level. Oh, and bad
nine,
judgment.
Eight.
Yeah, that's in. Yep, I was surprised he was going for that one. Obviously, we sit here up here and have a better view on shots like that, and he was drifting way wide. But he was really contemplating.
Ten. Nine.
That really took its time to make up its mind. Came over in the end, though.
Smashed by Yusuf here.
And all.
Well, left.
11-10, interval.
Well, he's been behind for most of the first half of the first game, but he gets in front in the end.
First, don't give him the soft one to spin it, because he took it three times there. Keep it in, even then, when I say the neutralizer, so give it a little bit more. On your serve, I see it at the end. He wants to come in and take the match. Just keep a little turns or give your serve a little bit more, because then we're in the game. As long as it's this away from that, you're absolutely dictating.
Yeah.
Last time, you can still continue with it.
Port 1, 20 seconds.
The advice of the coach, Jakob Høy, from England, was that to keep his opponent a little bit away from the net, push the shots a little bit further into the court in order for Huang not to get too close to the net and setting it off for his very nice
13,
smash.
10.
And I think that was very nice, solid, good advice. Because the only thing you really have to be considering when you play a player like Huang is that how to avoid for him to go on the full-blown attack all the time.
Cool, good.
Service yeah, over.
Good length.
11, 13.
Somehow he was almost forced to lose, to leave it. Didn't have many options to play.
service over.
Starting 14, to miss a 11. Few smashes now. Remember, he put one wide on the forehand sideline. That one into the net.
Yeah, Nusif has taken the rest at the moment, so not so many winners on the big power smashing anymore for the Singaporean player.
15-11.
So a 5-point lead now for Yusuf.
Yeah, I see now how he's reading it. The same very good reverse smash. But this time, Usyk is there waiting for it, anticipating it, and staying in the rally 11. And eventually winning it. That's really good play. Here comes that... that's the smash from Usyk. That's winning the shot. That was the advice of Jakob Hoy, not to do that, and here a very fine example why he gave that advice. Look at the reply from Huang here. Look at that. That's beautiful. Very nice play at the net. Something obviously he's very determined to do as he wants. Good lifts for his power smash.
Oh, he's left it drop, and it dropped in.
What a perfect length. It's a very difficult lift Usyk have to play here. Look at this, under pressure, but what a perfect length.
Yeah, just inside the line, yeah.
Doesn't get better than that. Very nice.
19-12.
Well, at one stage, Yusuf was 3 points behind at 5-8, but since then he's dominated this opening game. It is 8 game points.
Service over. 13-20.
Opportunity here for Rajiv Usyk, but still got plenty of game points. Such a short and sweet action from Huang, that attacking shot there. Didn't need much of time and space to play it.
Game.
Nice call out. And first game for Rajiv Usyk, 21-15.
First game won by Rajiv Usyk, 21-15.
Yeah, once he'd, as you suggested he would, come to terms with the power smashing and was able to get some of them back, he turned that game around in a very comprehensive fashion.
Yes, he did. He did really well.
Don't care about the net. You got it. Especially he will start doing the soft gloves to ask for it.
Yeah.
Just a little turn. Yeah. If you feel his descent a bit, just turn it a little bit. You need to cover it. On that you get one thing in your attack. You haven't used his body yet. You can also go for him if you have these big lefts. Okay. Yeah.
So once again, the emphasis in this interval on the English side was the net. Try to avoid it as much as possible, but you're doing well.
Second game, love all. Play. Serve is over. One love. Serve is over. One all.
Shake of the head.
I can't believe he missed it. Yeah, that's good.
Serve is over. Two.
Can you imagine if he was able to combine that? For more facilities in his game, you know, playing more variation to his shots and all that, how good he would be. How awesome he would be as a player. But it's just becoming too one-sided, it's becoming too easy to read and anticipate, and thereby he's getting into trouble. He's got to work on the overall game and not just on this fantastic smash he's got.
Drifts long on the drift.
Over. 3-2. Service over.
Nice smash into the body.
3-all.
Haven't seen his favourite smash yet, have we? The round the head one down the line?
No, not yet. But going back to the points of what I mentioned about Huang before, that he's got to work on his overall game, which I think might be a clear sign of Usyk actually doing that. He's not just relying on that smash anymore, but is trying to build other facilities into his game, which is good. I actually think in this rally what set it all up was an attacking clear by Huang from his backhand side straight down the line to the forehand side of Usyk, and then from there he went into that position and killed it at the net. Just a small example of what I'm trying to explain, you know, to play more variety on your shots.
Serve is over.
Another one of those missed smashes.
5-4.
Hi. There's a couple of times he's lifted over Huang, but pushed it long, and he's got to remember he is playing with the drift. 5-all.
Service over. 6-5. Service over. 6-all.
So far, this second game is very closely contested. And I think if Usyk is not really picking up, playing a little bit more pressure on his shots and adding on some pressure to his opponent, I fear that, you know, this is what we can see for the rest of the game. Completely even and a 21-19 situation. And who will win it? It will be very difficult to predict.
7-6.
Well, it may be a problem for Usyk to win it if he keeps just pushing the shuttle long. First time there's been a 2-point advantage to either man in this game.
Service over. 7-8.
This time Usyk coming out on top of a tight net exchange with the benefit of the net court.
See, that's what I mean. That's what Usyk has to do. He's got to put some authority into it, as what he did here. Getting very nicely out of that one. He was in deep problems the way. And then eventually having the chance and missing it.
Play, please.
Yeah, that was a good shot, wasn't it? Camera shot.
Service over.
Yeah, it's not a badminton shot.
9-all. Service over. 10-9.
Pace by Huang here, reading it and getting very, very early on this forehand here. That's very nicely played. Usyk is under great pressure, can't reach it despite his long legs.
That's nice.
Service over. 11-10. Interval.
So it's exactly the same score as at the first game interval. Usyk leading 11-10. I don't know, it's probably because we're guilty of stereotyping. We tend to think of the Chinese as fairly expressionless and, you know, giving nothing away but this man really shows his emotions. I know he's been in Singapore for a little while, but obviously his upbringing in China.
Eleven, ten, play.
First time Youssef has had a 2-point advantage in this game. Oh, what a chance.
13-10.
Perhaps took just too long a swing here.
Yeah, Youssef was really lucky to get away here. And I think he knows it. That wasn't well constructed.
Serve is over. 11-13. Serve is over. 14-11.
Pushed that long.
15.
Yeah.
11.
Youssef did well to get out of the way here from that push straight down the line. Sorry, straight down the middle. And once again, I feel now that Youssef is really sort of edging away.
Gliding away.
Gliding away, whatever you say. But I feel that he's slowly but surely just adding on to the margin, just 1 point at a time with a little bit of... No. It's nice and easy. 12-15. Possibly now go to 17-12. Let's see if that happens. It's always good fun to guess now and again.
Always worries me when you guess, Morten. The trouble is, nauseatingly, you're normally right.
I get many right. I get many. But, you know, sometimes I'm also getting them painfully wrong.
Serve is over. 16. 12. Over 13, 16.
You see, you said it was going to be 17-12.
Yeah, but it was close.
1 point, yes. But you've only asked him to win two.
Yeah, but he got the first.
All right, you were 50% right.
Yeah. Good defense from Youssef here. Huang really taking nice control of this rally. Youssef have to react to whatever is thrown at him. Look at that. Ah, that's a beauty. And that's so nice to see how he's taking 14, the pace off that shot,
60.
Playing that reverse drop shot rather than going for the big smashes. And look how effective that was. Look at this. Beautiful. Youssef is nowhere near it.
Serve is over. 17-14.
we can have a complete highlight of all the expressions of Huang when it comes. He's having some delightful ones. Well intercepted. Well read. Good anticipation here.
18-14.
Another one goes long, and these now are five match points for Rajiv Youssef. Oh. Yeah! Interesting way of changing his mind at the last moment there, Juan. But Rajiv Youssef is through to the quarterfinals, and it will be a battle between England and Scotland, because awaiting him in the last eight
match
is Kieran Merrilees.
England, 21-15, 21-15.
It's funny how 11-10 up in each game and then just drew away.
Yeah, every time, and it's really solid performance by Rajiv Youssef here.
Through in two straight games, each of them by the same margin, 21-15, 21-15. Another huge roar, because England have also just won a mixed doubles, the Adcocks beating Tan and Hu from Malaysia, 21-17, 21-11 on the adjoining court. So two big successes for England within a minute or two.
Representing England.
So the big question in this match was the enormous power smash from Huang. Was it enough to take him into the next round, into the quarterfinals? Or could Rajiv Youssef really get back into a match like this with an opponent with such a power smash as what we see here? But it was a very solid performance after Youssef is settling into this match. Really, his defense was up and running, and he managed to edge away from his opponent in both of the games from 11-10 up, and then winning quite comfortably in two games. As his coach was saying, Jakob Hoy was saying to Youssef, don't play the net too much, that's where Huang is good, where he's settling, setting up his winners. And here we've got the match point. Indecision, and then a very, very good cross-court smash right on the line. And Rajiv Youssef is ready for the quarter final tomorrow.